Hello, this is Solar Business TV, once again from Anaheim, from Solar Power International. And it's quite interesting because we have together with us the guy who came here from Mexico, Miquel Vidasola. So apparently maybe he will change the name to Build More Solar.
Yes.
So Miquel, I'm very happy that you are with us, yes, because you came from Mexico. I know that in the past you were in the Mexican Congress, one of the guys who was also supporting solar energy in the country.
Yes.
And now Mexico is finally, you know, like really kicking off, yes?
We're starting. Yes, Mexico today, it's becoming one of the most important niches in Central South America for solar. Wonderful new opportunities are starting to be open for different investors. About 70% of the whole territory of Mexico, it's a good solid candidate for solar projects. So the new energy reform that President Enrique Peña put in place, that I was able to participate directly as a congressman and had the opportunity to participate on it, will bring investment, will bring a lot of renewable energy into whole country, but specifically in my home state, which is the state of Baja California, which is very close to where we are located today. Mm-hmm. And yes, I'm a big fan and a big promoter of solar energy and renewable energy for the country of Mexico.
So you are able to change your name?
I really like that name, and I'm going to go and register right now at domainname.com, I think it's called, or something like that.
Yeah. Okay, Miquel. So, but actually, what I would like to ask you, because there is still quite a lot of issues, yes?
Yes.
And even you had some discussion on the booth.
Yes.
With PPA, with tenders, etc. So can you explain to the international audience what are the issues and how we can overcome, and eventually, if they get in touch with you, you know, how you can help?
Well, the first thing is that the energy reform in Mexico, it's very new. Mm-hmm. So trying to compare the energy to countries in Europe, places in Europe or in the United States or somewhere else, is where the energy reform has so much mature, it's something that has created some issues in the investment world. The investors are typically used to running a model, a way of doing things, that because of our energy reform being so new, there's still some things that we are working towards. There are some issues that could be improved, some amends that might be have to do with the reform itself, but also there's a learning curve experience that we need to go through. Not only ourselves, the developers and the investors, as myself and my company as Viga, but also the off-takers, the potential off-takers. Most of them, what they're looking is a low rate, and really, because that's what they want to lower their price in terms of what they're paying today. But there are different scenarios of what we can do. For instance, we have abasto aislado, we have generación distribuida, we have selling the energy as a generador or generator through a qualified supplier. But all those combinations, wow, just recently I was talking to another company about importing energy out of the United States into Mexico, to the border. So depending on where you're located and depending on what you're trying to accomplish, then there are different scenarios. Now, again, it's very new. For instance, importing energy out of the United States into Mexico might work for the border towns, might not work for trying to bring that energy into Cabo San Lucas. But maybe if in the industry in Cabo San Lucas for the hotels, maybe generación distribuida, or as you call distributor generation of energy, would be a perfect fit for the hotels. There are some other combinations instead. For instance, if you're trying to install less than half a meg, then you can do that on your rooftops, you can do that in your carports, and you don't need a permit or a license to do that. So if you can do the numbers where you're paying X amount of energy, and then you can determine how many solar panels and infrastructure you need, and that has a direct saving in terms of what you are today paying, and it brings a number that pays in X amount of years, for 499 less kilowatts, you don't need a permit. So the overall conception is that there's still a lot of education to be put in into this new energy reform, but in indication to the level of the potential off-takers, not to the qualified suppliers, not to the people that wrote the law, not to the people that are at SENASA or CFE.
Okay, but, so actually to the guys who will be off-taker of the projects, yes?
Yes, yes, specifically.
For the private PPAs, yeah?
For the private PPAs, and for them to understand what's available and how they can take advantage. Okay. And that's something that we are promoting. We're not just only developing and investing, we're also promoting education programs in different parts of the country and specifically in Baja California so that the potential off-takers start understanding that there's just not one solution. They might be two, three, four solutions depending on where they're located and what they're trying to accomplish.
So this is, Miguel, very interesting, yes, because next year we have our Solar Business Club and Solar Future Today.
Okay.
We are planning in March the event, Solar and Financial Leaders Summit.
Correct.
But maybe taking into account your feedback, we should also invite big potential off-takers, yes?
Yes, and those big potential off-takers are waiting for you to invite them. Yes. For instance, you can go to Canacintra, which is like the Chamber of Commerce of all the states, and there's national and world and Mexico Chamber of Commerce. You could also go to Canaco, which is the overall industry of restaurants, gas stations, etc.
So you will be our insider.
I can certainly will help you, and not only will I help you, I'm very interesting in promoting, because while I was a congressman, one of the main roles was to promote the energy, to promote renewable energy, and I believe that we need to do a better job in renewable energy and also in working with the environmental.
So last question, Miguel, because you know Mary O'Donnell, yeah? Because
yes.
Actually Mary, she brought us here together.
Yes, yes.
And so what we understood within our industry globally,
yes,
that solar is not B2B, not only B2C, but it's mainly H2H, human to human.
Yes.
And how this human to human is important in Mexico?
Well, it's very important because solar plays a role in Mexico today with the environmental, plays a role with a social impact also with the people, but also has a good fit in what the perception of the overall person's view and understand of solar. It has become something that they understand is good. It's something that will help improve, and it works hand in hand with the environmental, with the society. And that is very good because it gives us a lot of good willingness to continue moving forward with solar promotion and efficiency in Mexico.
Okay, so the last thing, do you know what is our flagship sign? Thumbs up for solar.
Always, yes. Thank you.
Thumbs up for solar. Thank you so much, Miguel. So maybe next time we will meet Miguel in Mexico City in March.
Well, not only will take your offer, but why don't we do this? I invite you to do a same show in the state of Baja California, and I would like to put together a good group of potential off-takers, which are called Fortune 500 companies, which are doing business at the border, a tremendous amount of business, tremendous amount of labor, and I think that it would be a wonderful opportunity to have you there, to host you there, and put a type of, let's say, coffee between friends with solar, and I think you're going to get a very good understanding of where we're going in the state of Baja California and Mexico with solar and what we're trying to accomplish.
Amazing. So actually before this interview, we didn't know we'd go there, but now the deal is done.
And it's 120 miles from here, so very close. And then we'll take him to eat some langosta, eat some beans and rice and a tecate beer, which we're very famous for down there, yes.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Solar Business TV from Anaheim.